Hi, Paul Evan here. Today I'd like to talk to you about view templates. View templates offer us a way to apply a collection of display settings to one or more views in a single step. New in 2013, we can apply a view template to a view in such a way that if the template settings change, those settings will get immediately applied to all associated views. So what I have here on screen is two sets of floor plans. I have a first and second floor plan on the left, and I have a first and second furniture plan on the right. And they obviously look very similar to one another at the moment. So what I want to do is change the display for the floor plans and make a separate set of display for the furniture plans, and I'm going to apply that using view templates. So let's start with the first floor plan. And what I want to do is highlight one of the pieces of furniture here that I don't want to see. On the Modify tab of the ribbon, I'll go to the display icon here and I'll choose Hide Category. And you'll see all the furniture in that floor plan disappear. Now I'm going to create a view template that captures those settings. So I'm going to come over here to the View Templates dropdown and choose Create a Template from the Current View. I'll give it a name, click OK. And then in the View Template dialog that appears, I'll click OK again. Now what I want to do is apply this view template to both the first and the second floor. So over here on the project browser, I'm going to select the first floor and the second floor plan, and I'm going to scroll down on the properties palette and locate the view template setting. It's currently set to none, but if I click that button, what I can do is apply my new typical floor plan view template to both of these views. Click OK. You're going to see the furniture immediately disappear from the second plan view to match the first plan view. Now, I want to make additional changes. I don't like the fact that the floor slabs have this stipple hatch pattern applied to them. Now, if I tried to address this issue in the standard way by going to the visibility graphics command, you'll see that everything here is grayed out. And the reason for that is because the view template is now in control of these views. So what I do instead is I go to the template dropdown, and I say I want to manage the view templates, select my typical floor plan, and I can get to the visibility graphic overrides here. So I'll edit this button. Now you'll see that everything is no longer grayed out. I'll scroll down, locate floors, override the surface pattern, and I just simply want to turn off the visibility. Let's click OK a few times, and you'll see that the surface pattern disappears from both views. Let's repeat the process over here in the furniture plan. So the first step is I'm going to create my view template, call it typical furniture plan. And then while I'm here, I'm going to go right to visibility graphics, override to remove the floor pattern. And I'm going to make one additional change as well. I'm going to override the annotation categories and I'm going to turn off the grid lines. Now I'm going to select both of the furniture plans on the project browser, scroll down, and apply the view template to both of those. And you'll see that those settings get applied. So using view templates is a great way to maintain overall office standards and maintain consistency. Thanks for watching.